Hello everyone and welcome back to Veluwe Zoo. And today is a very special episode because today we have the big reveal of the new Aqua House. Because as you might remember in the previous episode, I had no inspiration to do the Aqua House. So I gave someone the opportunity to build something for Veluwe Zoo. I put it in, I placed the building, I did all the foliage, fencing, and now it's time for a tour around the Aqua House. So this Aqua House was actually built by Leider or Leider. Nobody knows how to pronounce his name, but he is an amazing builder. You might remember him from the competitions. We did two competitions on the Discord. He won both. He makes some incredible stuff. So I gave him quite a challenge because, as you know, Veluwe Zoo is a franchise zoo, so I'm not able to send him the file, go ahead, make something. No, I had to give him like a blind shell basically. I gave him some walls, so I surrounded the area or where he was able to build. And then he went for it and made this amazing building. If you don't know Leider, if you want to see more, make sure you check out his YouTube channel. I will put a link down in the description. I will also try to put it in the upper right now. Please make sure you subscribe to him as well. He makes some amazing stuff. I'm much better most of the time than I do. But yeah, let's take a tour around the new Aqua House of Veluwe Zoo. So you might remember this part. So this is the part of the penguin habitat. We already did this little penguin sculpture. Of course, we made a lot of adjustments to it. And we have this beautiful sign here that says Aqua House. We will have to go up these stairs. So basically, the entire building was done by Leider, and some of the surroundings was actually done by me. So it did feel a little bit like a collab, but basically he told me what to do and where to put something. So yeah, well, let's go into the building. We will take a top look on the building, of course, in the end. You have these beautiful automatic doors, and then you come in to the building. We'll have these cool green walls. And then you'll have this. He told me it's like an information stand, so more like a hologram, so you can you will get the information on the screen. Of course, it's not really working in a franchise, so maybe in a sandbox you might be able to put some pictures on there. But if I do that in the franchise zoo, you will get a lot of messages. So that's why I didn't do that for now. So when we go in a little bit further, you will see these beautiful benches. And this is a really cool little trick that he did. These are actually usable, since this is the Australian bench, which is basically blended in with this beautiful planter. And guests are able to sit here and enjoy the view on the caimans. Really cool. So we have this beautiful little habitat, which was, a perfect struggle to put back in, because of course this building was a blueprint, and the blueprint doesn't save any terrain work, so we had to do that again. I think it's easier for me to switch to a top view right now, but I will quickly show you guys the size of the habitat. You will be able to see the caiman swimming here. You see a vet running around with some seals, actually, because I just put them in. Because I also made some adjustments on the seal habitat because of this building, but we will all see that in the end of the video. But yeah, you can walk around this habitat, as you can see some beautiful water here. And let's switch to a little top view of this habitat. There you go. Let's see if I can find the caiman. I was pretty sure that it's in here. Yes, there you go. One little caiman right over there. The habitat suits for the animals, so it has enough water space, it has enough land space, and it looks really, really cool. I actually already started on a building like this, and the habitat that I created didn't look anything like this, but this is just so much better. I can't express how happy I am with this building in Veluwe Zoo, because it's just finishing off everything, and I'm just super happy that I was able to continue building in Veluwe and didn't have to think about this building anymore. So let's continue the tour in Tegidcam. Here on the right we have some beautiful caiman sculptures, again with some information stands, and on the right we have a penguin viewing It was also a struggle for him to make a building that has like a tropical area, but also a beautiful penguin viewing gallery, because I already made these glass windows, as you might remember in the video, to have like an indoor viewing section for the penguins. But of course, he nailed it and made it, just perfect. A beautiful little penguin viewing gallery do we have here. I made some little adjustments on the inside, so I put some concrete in here just to make it look a little bit more finished in the habitat itself. There's the staff entry. A really cool little thing. So it's like an education stand. So we have an educator point right there. And you can imagine that it will have an educator telling about the animals. And a lot of stuff around it. I think it's a really cool place. Some beautiful benches and the murals that I already used. He put them back in. But look at that. You'll have a perfect view on the penguins. It's really cool. Made some little adjustments here on the rock work so they are able to go up there. Made some enrichment items over there so they will actually use this place. And it's really cool. I would sit here all day and watch these beautiful animals. Let's continue along this side. Of course, again, the statues, all the little details here. And then we go back into the tropical area of the aqua house. And let's see. You'll see some quick jumps in time sometime if I change the lighting. As you might know, I'm not able to change the weather in this zoo. So I have to make sure there's some decent lighting in this building. So let's continue. A beautiful exhibit over here. There's some really cool details that we have to point out here. So this is the terrapin exhibit. Oh, you will see some changes in time right now. Oh, well, good morning, everyone. But there's something really cool. We have a double exhibit right here. So he made some adjustments. So he put some mulch in here, some rock work, and actually made a little gate right there. So it actually looks like a double exhibit. But of course, they are not able to use it. But it looks like they can. So he adjusted a little bit of the foliage, made some cool effects right there. So it's a really cool little trick, and I just love it what he did here. So let's continue the tour along this way, and as you might see already, there's a polar bear there. Why is there a polar bear? Well, I don't know. You might remember from streams and stuff like that, people are always complaining that there are no polar bears in Veluwe Zoo. So that's why Leider put some polar bears in there, of course. On the back, you will see Feeny Pops Foundation. Well, who the hell is Feeny Pops? Well, Feeny Pops is actually one of my first moderators. And you might have seen it in one of the live streams. I put some names with some stars in the beginning of Veluwe Zoo. People that helped me out and, yeah, should give some, get some credit. Of course, I always forgot about Feeny Pops. So that's why she got her own foundation right here and a little museum area just for Feeny Pops together with a polar bear, which is beautiful. Again, some really cool tricks here. You will have the gravel flooring. You will have some moss on the floor, and a beautiful little lighting right there because of the glass window. You will have a perfect view, or like a perfect lighting on this animal. Yeah, I like this place. Really cool use of these Planet Zoo banners to make the walls, because they have this shiny structure on them. I really like that, and it's just a little I don't know what it is. It's just a random polar bear inside a aquatic building. So on this side, you will still have the same viewing on the Cayman, and on the back you will have some staff buildings. Nothing is super interesting to see over there. Basically, I think we put like a trade center in. But yeah, there are a lot of buildings in there, because as you might remember, I already put all the staff buildings in this place and I wanted to incorporate them in the building. He did, and they are basically all around the place. I will ask him to put it on the workshop so he can give me a link to it, so you guys can check it out yourself. Because you might remember, I'm not able to put Veluwe Zoo on the workshop in the end, which is sad, of course, but yeah. That's just the way it is. Then on the outside, just a small little area with the manager's cafe. And another thing that's going on in the Discord, Leider is basically the Veluwe Zoo manager, because he's always helping me out with choosing which rocks, choosing which foliage. So he's managing everything for me. So he made his own cafe, of course, again, with a beautiful polar bear in the window. But then, a really nice little seating area. Like cool little coffee shop, I think, that's in there. Some nice seating areas on the outside. And we finished it up with some nice fencing. And you will have the desert building in the back. As you can see, I changed the entrance, but we will take a look at that in the end. The monorail goes along this side, and we will have the Africa area on that side. Let's continue back in the building. I really love the outside, by the way. We will take a top view, of course, but that is a little view on the side. Again, the Aqua House sign, a cool little seal on there. Just a perfect building. Also, another challenge that I gave him, because I wanted this to be a blueprint, so I wanted him to stick with 4,000 pieces. He didn't make it, it was like 4,500, so it was two blueprints, but still this this building is quite piece efficient. And as you can see, there's also a top floor right there, so let's continue along this path. You'll have some beautiful fountains over here. And another stairs, really cool. You can imagine that putting the pathing back in took us around 2 or 3 hours. That was nice. It's not really friendly for pathing, so if you want to use this building, make sure you all have enough time to put it back in. But as you can see, it's worth it. So this is the top floor. You will have an outside viewing area right over here, and you can take a look at the penguins again. Look at that, a top view of the penguins. I had to change the habitat a little bit, so I made some adjustments to this side, and you will now also have a view right in there, so inside the indoor area for the penguins, which is really cool. And you will just have a overall nice view on Veluwe Zoo. Look at that, you can sit here all day, right? Enjoying the view and the 15 frames per second that we currently have in Veluwe Zoo. I have around 7,500 guests walking around in the zoo, so I think my computer is still doing pretty well. But I hope with the new sandbox project I can do a little bit more than this, because we really have to think about the pieces and about the animals that we are using, because of the amount of guests that we need to still make some money in the franchise zoo. But yeah, just enjoy this little view for a while, some nice sunshades. You can already imagine having your lunch here, having your breakfast here, cool little restaurant, might be cool for this area. Some benches, again, really cool stuff. So there's one more little thing I want to show you guys, because this building is actually quite useful for me. So if you go through this door, you will have a nice little staff area. Of course, not perfectly decorated, but for me it's really useful, so everything is that I need is in here, which is nice. The entrance towards the seal habitat is now on the back of this building, but we will take a look at that right now. So the building itself is a little top view. I just put it to pause to get some extra frames per second, but look at that building, it's beautiful, really modern structure. I always love that, and I think it really fits the area. It's blended in perfectly with the penguin habitat now, with the terrain. I might do some little rock work here and there, but I already blended it in really nicely over here as well. So basically I got the building, and then the terrain work was still one big mess, so I made this little wall on the side and the fencing. I put some lighter designs right there, just to give him some credit for this beautiful building, because he just did an amazing job on it. But look at that, it's really cool. So the manager's cafe on this side, all the green stuff, it just blends in perfectly. So we did another little thing right over here. So this area wasn't really finished yet, so I made this cool little aquarium with some piranhas in there. I know it might not be the most realistic thing because it's open. I wanted to make like a cave thing, but that was too much, and it basically blocked the entire building. I didn't want that. These fish, you can find them on a workshop. I think they were made by Wiser together with these birds. They are really cool and really fits this area. I will zoom out for a little bit so I can show you guys what I did with this area. I changed the pathing a little bit right there. I made a new entrance to the desert building. We will zoom into that later. I made some viewing spots for the seals, as you can see. Because first, the staff gate was right in the middle, right there. And it didn't really fit. It was weird. But now we have this building, so the staff gate is perfectly placed over there. And we have some cool viewing spots for the guests to take a look at the seals. I used the betty platforms as a viewing or like a flooring and the gates. I changed the pathing right here to gravel because I think it looks really nice. Still the same viewing stuff for the others. That's basically, yeah, that didn't change much. Only the staff entrance with like a water treatment, because the other water treatment is right there and it didn't reach this water. So the water became dirty. We didn't want that. It's still thinking about the animal welfare. So that's good. We placed fencing all around the place. That took me hours and hours, and I finished off all the foliage work. As you can see, the only thing I need to do here is fix the monorail. But yeah, it's just a really nice little finished area. The penguin habitat on this side. And it just looks really, really nice, in my opinion. Of course, let me know down in the comments what you think of this area. I'm super happy that it's finished. And I will quickly show you the new entrance to the desert building. As you can see, it was highly inspired by Lyda, but I didn't make a cool entrance for this building yet. It was like a big opening and you just go through it and then you were in the building. First it was desert, now it's desert, but it looks really nice. So I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure you hit the like button, subscribe if you haven't already, and also make sure you are moving over to Lyderist channel. Click the subscribe button, click the like button, watch some of his videos. You will be inspired by the amazing builds that he will create. Hopefully I can invite him back into one of the next projects so he can make some cool buildings again. But yeah, we will see what the future holds. I wish you all the best, and I will speak to you guys in the next video. Goodbye, you.